Might want to call a power company. Woohoo! Honda there.
Where's it coming from?
I'd say it's gonna make it to 10th Street.
Oh my God.
Yeah, that's pretty.
Okay, that's going over to that transformer over there. So that ain't gonna fall down in front of us. Found something else to burn up. Pretty.
Well, we're across the street now.
Now we got a hot line across the street. This is Adrian Hart with your Southeast Colorado News on seconews.org. We're in Rocky Ford, where our Rocky Ford fire chief, we're just in time for the train, right?
Yeah, we've had a lot of trains coming through right now.
It's actually been a really busy scene for you guys through the whole fire.
It sure has.
Do you want to tell us about the incident and how it started?
So earlier this afternoon, we got paged out to this incident. It started over here on the east side of the over on Railroad and 12th Street. And it seemed to have started in some grassy area. And then just the winds picked up and just kind of took it from there. The area has some high grass and some high weed content within it. And it just took off from there. This area's got a very well, like a construction warehouse type setup out here. And once it hit inside some of them storage buildings, it just took off from there.
So kind of kindling on the fire was the dry brush on the property.
Absolutely, and the wind just kind of took it from there and just rolled it through from one storage section to another, and we just could not catch it.
I think we're gonna take a pause on the interview for the train real quick.
Sounds good.
So this incident began this afternoon with the dry brush catching fire. Do we have any cause at this point?
We don't. We have somebody that was seen near the area, but nobody's seen anybody actually light the fire. So outside of that, we don't have much more information.
So actively under investigation?
Yes.
All right. If people have information, they can contact the dispatch, right?
Yes, at 719-254-3344.
Okay. This fire particularly challenging in several different ways. Do you want to talk a little about that?
Yeah, you know what made this fire extremely challenging was the amount of structures and the fuel loading that was inside the structure, because this was a construction storage for a construction company. So there was a lot of construction material inside, from lumber to asphalt to refrigerant. So all the different hazardous components to this fire just made it very difficult. And the other difficult part of this fire was the power lines. As the power lines were burning off, they were still charged lines, so our trucks were limited to what they could do, where they could travel, because the lines were still hot.
Yeah, we walked up on those lines. I'd seen someone notified us of it, so thank you for shooting us that message that there were hot wires on the ground that went over the scanner.
Yes.
And so we knew to watch for those. And right in that adjacent parking lot where everybody was parking, there were hot lines on the ground.
Yes, there were.
So a very dangerous situation there. Also, we heard explosions during the fire. Those, some of those refrigerants you're talking about?
Yeah, so that was part of the refrigerants that just got to that point where they just exploded. And then there was also some little propane tanks in there as well that breached it. That's what exploded you were hearing. There could have been some ammunition inside as well. It's hard to tell. There's a lot of popping, and it was a very dangerous situation, but everybody pulled together very well. La Junta, Rocky Ford, Antonola, Fowler, you know, the law enforcement agencies, the Terre County Sheriff's Office, Rockport PD, you know, Black Hills Energy. You know, there's so many components and working parts to this fire that, man, there was no injuries to report. Everything's good, but unfortunately, we weren't able to save the entire structure.
So you guys didn't go in because there was risk if you guys go in there?
Yeah, there was way too much risk. So it was a fire that we call a defensive fire. So we just make sure that we did exposure protection, watch for spotting everywhere around us, just to make sure that there's no spot fires causing this fire. Because the wind was carrying very hard to the west and carrying very large smoke wing to the west.
So again, no injuries in this fire, no pets injured?
No pets that we're aware of.
Okay. And it didn't spread beyond the property, right?
It did not. It stayed within the property, and we were able to contain it into the property. Now, there's going to be some smoldering going on throughout the night, so if people start noticing some smoldering, there's some smoke haze in the area. This is probably going to be smoldering for quite some time.
Okay, but you've got guys here mopping up.
Yes, we do, and we're going to have guys here throughout the night also keeping an eye on it, just to make sure that everything stays safe. Nobody will have anything to worry about. We'll take care of it.
Awesome. Thank you for keeping our community safe, Ray.
Thank you, Adrian. Appreciate it.
All right. For the Rocky Ford Fire Department, Fire Chief Ray Gonzalez, with your Southeast Colorado News, I'm Adrian Hart. This is Adrian Hart with your Southeast Colorado News on seconews.org. We're here in Rocky Ford at the Harwood Fire. Day number two. Rocky Ford Fire Department keeping that smoldering debris under control and monitored, and they do have it contained to the lot. We've got more video to release from our viewers. We've got a photo gallery or two or three we're going to release. Of course, we want to encourage you guys to support the Rocky Ford Fire Department tonight at the Elks Lodge for their annual Fireman's Ball. Your update today is that it is being monitored by our Rocky Ford Fire Department to keep the public safe. With your Southeast Colorado News from the Harwood Fire in Rocky Ford, Colorado, I'm Adrian Hart.